ready to start, and right at that moment, someone starts a skill saw, you know, starts cutting. This is the world, isn't it? When can you get started? You just have to get started no matter what's happening in the world. Fortunately, I have this microphone close, so it is not going to ruin it. I guess we're all waiting for the right time. There is no right time. There is no time at all, actually. We just have to get started no matter what's happening in the world. But probably we shouldn't be paying too much attention to what's going on in the world, because that this sort of fosters this idea that there's so much going wrong in the world that I better not even get started until things get better. You know, it seems like, just not being aware at all of various things that are going on in the world. Of course, the news condenses all the bad stuff, you know, makes it seem terrible, but it's better don't pay any attention, which I've not been doing for quite some time now. A little bit seeps through, of course, but just don't pay attention. And keep focusing on the practice. The practice, the practice, the practice. Last night I had a dream, and the ego asked me, you know, what's causing the problems? The ego's asking. And I said, well, it's the japa. The japa-ing, which means the assertions. I said, this is what causes you the most trouble. Like I was advising the ego. The ego wanted to know. That's what causes the ego the most trouble, is the assertions, is the repetitive assertions. And so that's what we should be doing. That's what we should be doing, actually. Then I said, why am I advising the ego? That's crazy. And then in the morning I started doing all these repetitive assertions, and it was very helpful. So what we will start out here with is a blockbuster. And that is to say, I don't need the dawn when I already have the day. Or I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. Now this can be a very powerful catalyst for your what? What is it that we're aiming for? Okay, ultimately we're aiming for that shift of perception. The shift of perception is virtually imperceptible in terms of difficulty. It's not like you're standing on your head and you suddenly say, oh, now I can see properly. It's just a slight change of emphasis. Slight change of emphasis. So, and yet, that slight change of emphasis goes from dawn to day, actually, from dawn to day. We don't want to be stuck in the dawn. Okay, we don't want to be stuck. This is the problem that we're facing now. The fourth phase gets us over this problem. The first three phases get us into this notion of the dawn, the dawning of truth, you know, dawning up, but we can stay stuck in the dawn, where it just stays perpetual dawn. Well, this is what we have to go beyond. And what we do this, yes, I already know that I don't need the dawn because I already have the day. 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 Who needs the dawn when they already have the day? So, of course, there are going to be jitters going from dawn to day, but this is what our aim is here, okay, going from dawn to day. And the way to get to the day is to say, I already have the day, I'm already in the day. To accustom yourself, acclimatize your expectations to, this is what I'm going to experience. As soon as I open my eyes, as soon as I shift my perception, I'm going to be in the fullness of the day, the fullness of the day. No dawn, I've already been there, done that, I don't need the dawn. When I already have the day. Who needs the dawn when they already have the day? I don't need the dawn. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. The day is what I really want. The fullness, which is what we really want. The fullness of realizing the unbornness of all. the all-inclusive, non-dual, unborn oneness. Okay, the all-inclusive, non-dual, unborn oneness, which is what? The Godness. The Godness. Is there a God? Well, it's better to say there is the Godness. The Godness is. Not Goddess. The Godness. N-E-S-S. The Godness. The Godness is. The Godness is. There's just this unbornness. This oneness. This fresh unbornness. That already is. This is called the fullness of the day. The dawn is when we are getting very high concepts and trying to get some glimpse of some light somewhere. We might see a little glimmer in the sky, and we say, "Oh, maybe the dawn is coming." And it's not quite as dark. It's still everything's still very much in darkness, except on the horizon. You see it's lightening up just a little bit, and we think, "Oh, wow, that's great. It's lightening up a little bit." But then we can get stuck there for a long time of thinking, "This is it. This is it. This is it. Now, what can I do with this?" But we're past that now. We're past the dawn. We are here. I don't want the dawn. I've already got the day. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. So I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. So we're... The dawn, here's what the dawn is. The dawn is when we know it's there, we know the truth, we intuitively know it, we're working on it, and we're all ready for it, so to speak, but our eyes are still closed. We don't see it. So we're seeing through our eyelids, shut eyelids, and when you close your eyelids, it seems like outside is just kind of dawn, because it's pretty much dark, but it's a little bit of light, so it's dawn. Open our eyes, oh my gosh, all the light is already here. Everything's already here. It's already here. The Godness is already here. So the last step is to open our eyes, to shift our perception. And this is what we're working on here. Because without that, we'll stay in this dawnness. And if we think that's it, then we'll become a pundit. We'll begin to try and be an authority on, spiritual history and comparative theology and all this kind of stuff, thinking that somehow this is the highest achievement, when it's not at all. It's not at all. It lacks a complete understanding of the path, because only when we shift our perception do we experience then the completeness of the path. This is why the ego can never be our guide, because the ego stops at the dawn. It goes no further, and so it's very incomplete in its advice. Very incomplete in its advice. Knowing that it doesn't satisfy, its goal doesn't satisfy, it tries to delay as long as possible, even getting to the dawn, because then we'll realize, hey, this doesn't really satisfy, and then it'll say, well, you need to be a pundit, okay, and they say, that doesn't satisfy, and so then you say, wait a minute, there's something wrong with this. So the ego knows it's a lousy advisor, so it tries to slow you down and delay you as long as possible from realizing this. That's a subjective, right? If you were a lousy advisor and you had this lousy goal that nobody really wants, and that's all you had, wouldn't you slow someone down as long as possible to actually getting to that destination? Because then they're going to say, "Wait a minute, this is it. This is what you have for me. Oh, that's terrible. I'm not going to use you as an advisor anymore." So the ego's game is to slow you down as much as possible. Slow you down as much as possible. So, how could that be a good advisor to getting free of misery? As you're slowed down as much as possible, you're still in this very, very, very frightful, miserable state. And it just prolongs it. The ego just prolongs all that misery and suffering. So, we don't need the ego. We need the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the advisor which has the total view. The total view. The total view. Not the dawn view, but the full day view. So, the Holy Spirit knows everything. The completeness of what the path really is about, what the spiritual reorientation is truly about, it has the true knowledge and understanding of that. And only that can truly advise us, right? Because only that can save us time, whereas the ego is trying to delay us as much as possible. The Holy Spirit's trying to speed it up as much as possible. So completely different agendas there. So we don't want the ego. Who needs the ego when we have the Holy Spirit? I don't need the ego when I already have the Holy Spirit. I don't need the dawn when I already have the day. I don't need the dawn when I already have the day. So obviously, when you see the day, you realize the dawn was just because we had our eyes closed. Actually, the day has always been here. So imagine if you wake up and you've been sleeping, you wake up and you stretch and you're breathing you're all ready to get up, except your eyes are still closed. And you kind of move your head around like this and you say, wow, what time is it? I don't know, but what is it like outside? Well, it must be the dawn, right? Just the early, early dawn, because I'm only seeing a tiny bit of light here. I'm only seeing a tiny bit of light. And you say, okay, it's the dawn. Well, I need to wait then until the day comes, you know, before I get up. I don't really want to get up in the dawn here. So you keep your eyes closed. Well, you keep your eyes closed for an hour, 2 hours. Then you look around and say, it's still the dawn. Oh, okay. You wait longer and longer and longer. Your eyes are still closed. You look around, it's still the dawn. You say, this is kind of, and then you start thinking, well, maybe this is all there is. There isn't the fullness of the day. It's just the dawn. That's it. And then you start saying, well, I'm not going to get up then. I'm just going to start thinking in my mind and adjust to this. Okay, this is the typical problem we have. The truth of the matter is, when we wake up, we stretch, and we're all ready to get up, but our eyes are closed, and we're looking around, and we say, oh, it's the dawn. The truth of the matter is, it's not the dawn. It's only appearing that way because our eyes are closed. The fact is, if we were to open our eyes, we would see the fullness of day. In fact, the fullness of day is always present. It's always present. The fullness of godness, unbornness, is always present. It's just our eyes are closed and we're interpreting as if it's the dawn because we're just getting barely, you know, totally filtered through our closed eyes. So we're very perplexed. We say, well, how do I go from the dawn to the day gradually, you know? And we think that there's something happening with external to us. It's not. It's actually our own eyes closed, which make it seem like it's the dawn. When we open our eyes up, we'll see, oh, it's the fullness of the day is already here. And we say, how did that happen? Huh, it's already, how'd that happen? Well, it didn't happen. It was already there. So it's the already-ness we need to keep practicing. The fullness of the day is already here. Yes, I already know that the fullness of the day has always already been here. Yes, I already know that the fullness of the day has always already been here. Yes, I already know that the fullness of the day has already always been here. And it's just an illusion when our perception is not seeing it, shut down to it, that makes it think that it's just dawning. All right, there isn't actually any dawning. The day never actually dawns. The fullness of the day actually, it's all the fullness of truth is always present. The all-inclusive, non-dual. The all-inclusive, non-dual oneness is already present. The all-inclusive, non-dual, unborn oneness is always present. The all-inclusive, unborn, non-dual oneness is always fully present. It's fully present right now. It's always been fully present. So we need to look at this and get clear. And what our role is in deceiving ourselves is to the mistake of thinking because our eyes are closed that we think that it's only dawn out there. And so we wait for a change out, you know, change around us for the fullness to happen. And it doesn't happen because our eyes are closed. So we keep thinking it's the dawn. It's still the dawn. It's still the dawn. It's never the dawn, actually. It's never the dawn. Reality is never in a condition where it's dawning, actually. It's always completely present. Just like here, now. How can now dawn? Now is fully now. Okay, and the dawning is the belief in time that somehow that now is gradually dawning. No, now is already fully present. So as we practice here, this full stop and the wow, and the way our practice, which is the guru, is to say, wow, this is starting to, you know, seeping into me. This is amazing information. And that's the shock, is to recognize, as we recognize that Godness is already fully present. Fullness of the day is already present. It's always been that way. And so as we touch upon this very important topic, for sure we're going to get a shocks of recognition here. And this is the wow. I'm already feeling it. And this is good. When you get a shock of the wow, it means that recognition has taken place. The shock of recognition is the wow. And so we just full stop in that. We don't press forward right this moment. Don't compare it to anything else. Don't start drawing comparisons to some sort of natural shock of nature. Oh, look at that. No, this is unique. This is very unique. So we have been deceiving ourselves all along. And now you know why everyone remains asleep. Even those who think they've done everything they can possibly do, they're still asleep. Because they're waiting. They say, well, I can't wake up until the fullness of the day comes. You know, it's still dawn, so what's the point in getting up? I'm waiting. And they believe that, you know, that they're waiting. No, and nobody can do it. And anybody who claims that they're in the fullness of the day, they say, you're crazy. You're a deceiver. Because it's still the dawn. And this is the overwhelming feedback that you get in this world. Is everybody thinks that there's these cycles in terms of that there's a becomingness that is taking place. And we need to wait for all that to work out. Is absolutely not true. The fullness of the day is already here. It's already completely present. It always has been. The fullness of what? The unbornness. Everything is already fully unborn. Everything is already completely unborn. Everything is already completely unborn. Yes, I already know that everything is already completely unborn. Yes, I already know that everything is already completely unborn. So we're working against this extreme skepticism here in this world. Because of this trouble I've just pointed out with our perception being shut to truth and only opening up a tiny bit so it thinks, oh, truth is still in the process of getting itself together, you know, getting arranged, becoming, and say, oh, well, it's not quite ready for me yet. You know, it's not quite ready for me yet. The unbornness is what? The unbornness is in the process of becoming unborn? No, it's already, that which is already perfectly unborn is already perfectly unborn. Everything is already completely unborn. Which is what the father of Advaita Vedanta, the teacher of Shankara's teacher, I'm not sure, can't remember the name, but Gaudapada or something, said the ultimate realization is that there's nothing that's ever been born. This is unbornness, absolute unbornness. That is the ultimate realization. This is what all teachings are pointing towards. You want to use Vedanta as an example. So everything is already completely unborn. Everything is already completely unborn. Right now, It's already right. Everything is already right now, completely unborn. Everything has always already been completely unborn. And so you hear the skepticism of the skill saw, you know, and this is the world. You realize you're stepping into a situation of extreme skepticism. Okay. Because they're saying that you're only imagining the fullness of the day, because they can plainly see it's not there yet, because their eyes are, their perception's shut, and they say, well, no, it's obvious that it's only the dawn. So you're going about saying, hey, I'm in the fullness of the day. They say, well, you got a great imagination, but it's not there yet, because we all know it isn't. We can tell. This is the trouble in this world. This is the trouble. This is why it's so seemingly difficult to wake up, is this intense skepticism in the world. This is what I ran into coming into this world. I thought it would be easy. I said, I see it. You know, what do you mean? It's just open your eyes and you can see. And they say, what are you talking about? I'm not going to open my eyes until the fullness is there. Obviously, it's not there yet. And so this causes lifetimes and lifetimes of absolute misery for us. So at least explaining this, clarifying it, now you start to say, aha. Aha, aha, aha. And it's like this aha moment, which is a wow, isn't it? I don't want to talk through the wow too much here, because I'm feeling it too. Did you remember there was a point in your life where people just put you down too much, and you said, I just can't take this. I want to be able to be accepted in the world. And everybody's putting me down by saying, you have such a very extreme imagination. It's just too much, actually. You know, you need to somehow temper it, because everybody knows that we're not yet in the world is not yet advanced enough to be in the fullness of God. You know, we have to earn that. We have to, you know, improve. You know. And this is dualistic delusion. This is the heart of dualistic delusion. And you get the ridicule and the skepticism from that. And eventually this causes you to shift your perception into this dawn state at best. And then from there you're probably so forlorn that you closed your eyes even tighter and went into deep, deep darkness. Thinking, oh, yeah, I was wrong. My imagination was wrong. But you knew, and then you became conflicted within, very conflicted. Because you knew that this wasn't so, and yet all the skepticism was telling you, you know, that no, there is no fullness yet. You have to wait. We're all working on it here. Everyone says, well, why do you think we're all working on it? What are you talking about? It's already complete. No, our whole purpose here is to complete it. And we would say, no, the purpose of trying to complete it is actually a clever denial of it. So you're all here denying truth. Why? Trying to trick God in order to lower God, make God less than what God is, so we can feel that we're therefore greater than God. So that's what everyone's here for. But yet we can give a different purpose for being here. We can give a different purpose. We can change our purpose. Since the whole thing is based on faith anyway, there's nothing that says we can't flip faith and decide, hey, you know, my purpose here is to realize that the fullness actually is here. It already is present. There's nothing I need to do to make it so. There's nothing I need to do to make everything already completely unborn, because it's already completely unborn. Nothing is ever is born. Nothing is ever crystallized. Nothing is ever born. Nothing is ever crystallized. Everything is completely unborn already. Everything is already completely unborn. So we're honing in on this intense skepticism, which prevents us from shifting our perception, actually. If you ask, well, how come I can't shift my perception? Because of this intense skepticism, which you think that you're only going into some imaginary condition, which somehow will make you fall behind everyone else who's actually sees it correctly and is working on to fix, you know, try to force the dawn to gradually, you know, become, gradually move towards completeness of fullness of day. You think that you'll just be on a side trip, you know. This is not true at all. It's the others that are on the side trip. And yet numbers tend to intimidate us, don't they? Quantity. If the whole world is saying you're wrong, that you're just a foolishly imagining this and deceiving everyone, then it's possible, you know, your spirit could be crushed and just feel like I'm, you know, what's the use? I might as well, you know, maybe I am wrong, and you start doubting yourself, doubting the truth. Start doubting the truth. And we're certainly right here, right now. We're certainly right here, right now, right? Talking about this, seeing it right here, right now. And this is really happening. This is really happening that we're right here, right now, looking at this. So this is a wow. This is a wow. This is a wow. This is the factor that ultimately has kept us from happiness, that has kept us in misery. Of course, even if you explain it, everybody will say, well, you know, nobody agrees with you and everybody agrees with me. So, you're voted off the island, so to speak. And she said, well, truth is not at the mercy of a vote. You know, you don't get the insane to vote and claim that they're sane and the therapist is insane, and that doesn't make it true. So voting that lies are true doesn't make the lies true. Only the insane would believe so. And those who say that the complete unbornness isn't here already are in a state of insanity. For sure. Mistakenness, severe mistakenness. So, to look at this a little further, you might say that those who are afraid to awaken, they're afraid of what the reaction to them awakening. You know, they say, I can't handle it. People will say, I'm crazy. I won't be able to handle it. So they're telling you, no, don't do it. You can't handle it. Well, say, yes, I can handle it, you know, because I prepared. Now, if you haven't prepared for it, then of course you might succumb to pressure. That's why the spiritual path gradually builds up a foundation of certitude, you know, that it's okay. And we're not likely to, once we get flying, we're not likely to crash. This is why we're getting used to the full stop and the wow, full stop and the wow. See, if they think it's imagination, then they'll say, wow, you're trapped in your imagination forever because you're enjoying it so much, you're saying it's so wonderful. You'll never be able to get out of that imagination. And as soon as you think it's imagination, then you'll panic because you'll say, oh my gosh, I don't see any way out of this imagination because I can see everything's already completely unborn. And so the only way to get out of this imagination is to be born. You see, and I don't see any way to be born. And so you're going to panic, you see. And so if you get a glimpse of this, you might get really jittery, you know. If you're not prepared, you get frightened. Say, oh my gosh, there's no way out. There's no way out of the perfect, complete unbornness that is. No way to be born. Uh-oh. So if you take it that it is imagination, that's when this dreadful panic will set in. And that's when you'll identify with the body and say, oh, let me identify with something that's born, you know, that's born. But even the body isn't born, although it's a convention to say that it is. So what this world is just a whole bunch of conventions. And the world has all these conventions to reassure us, to get us out of this completeness, complete unbornness, by identifying with what we conventionally define as bornness. So if we identify with bornness here by the conventions of the body, things, nature, etc., then we think, oh, we've escaped our imagination that all is completely unborn and are now on the path to salvation of what's really true, which is, you know, becoming, we think, time, space, process, and form. So it completely flips things upside down, doesn't it? We're completely flipped upside down here in this world by identifying with what we, conventions of bornness. And again, yeah, full stop in the wow, I'm like, wow, this is, you know, I'm reeling. My psyche is just reeling at this information. And again, I don't plan these videos so much, really. It's just I say, okay, I'm going to do it and do my best. And whatever comes up, you know, just trust it. It's always been whatever comes up is better than I expect. That's why I keep doing it. Way better than I expect. So I'm like, you know, giddy. I feel like a little giddiness. This is, you know, wowness. It's like this is better than I expected. Wow. This is really right on point, you know, right on top. It's just illuminating. It's very illuminating. Clarity is very illuminating. So and we get used to this giddiness and let it settle down. Eventually, giddiness settles down, doesn't it? Your mind gets sort of used to it, and you settle down. So you're no longer so giddy. You're no longer so wowed out. But we give it some time. This is not a 10-minute video here. Or we have to rush through. That's not right. You deserve better. You deserve to have this and be marinated in this wow. Because that's what helps you, is to allow this to marinate within you. Oh, bird. And the birds come down from the sky, stop, they look at you like, is everything okay? The birds are always nervous when they're on the ground, aren't they? Just like we're always nervous when we're identifying with a conventional definition of bornness, aren't we? It's like we're on the ground, you know. Oh, I'm in a body. Oh my gosh, this is weird. We're not in a body. We're just identifying with a convention of bornness, thinking that frees us from this imagination that all is already unborn, that we think that somehow that's our imagination and it's wrong. See, this is, you know, that's upside down and backwards. It's not imagination. Identifying with bornness is imagination. Identifying with bornness is imagination. So, there's no doubt, this is clickety, clickety, click. This is like, wow. The shock of recognition here. The shock of recognition. I remember a dream I had long ago. Back maybe in 1980 or something. the connection just started out, so I'm going to have to edit this video, which means I got to keep it under 2 hours. And I'm not sure how long the first one went. Anyway, that's okay. So we need to full stop on the wow here. That's okay, full stop on the wow. See, we can always get back to full stop in the wow here. When you feel unstable, when you feel something happen like this, okay, full stop in the wow. You don't have to do anything other than that. Trust that you already, the information is already registered. Now it's just marinating, letting it come, get in. Just trust in that. Because you know it's true. You know, we know it's true. Now, do others have any idea what you're doing? No. So, of course, they're not going to treat you properly. They're going to try to pull you into their dramas without any realization whatsoever that you're in this tremendous wow. This is the trouble, the insane skepticism of this world, thinking that identifying with the conventions of bornness is how we escape the inescapable imagination of complete unbornness. This is the skepticism of the world that puts this terrible pressure on us. But this full stop in the wow is patient mode. We're just being patient with this. It's kind of like this. We've seen something tremendously important for our own well-being, for our mental health, right? We've just seen something tremendously important for our mental health, to optimize our mental health. So of course we're feeling like this, wow. So we don't need to look at it again exactly right now. It's more like, well, what's our reaction to it? How are we reacting to what we've already seen? And there's this inner vibration, you know, like enthusiasm, like almost like a frantic enthusiasm, like, oh my gosh. A little bit of continuity fear, like, oh wow, I don't know if I'm ready for the fullness of the day. And sort of a mixture of churning, just, wow, this really just brought up, you know, a huge, huge complex into the light, right? And so let the complex kind of, let the dust settle, because the complex, has fallen apart. It's already fallen apart, actually. This complex has already fallen apart. And so just let all the parts settle down, let all the dust settle. We're not trying to put it back together again, the complex. So what's it feel like to be free of this complex? Well, eventually we'll know, but right now, it's all the stuff is still settling down, all the dust is still settling, all the parts that went into holding this complex, you know, together now, all kind of just tumbling and rolling away. And we're fundamentally different now, actually. Fundamentally different. So this, when I say wow, it means that we've shifted already some important aspect. And we're fundamentally different than we were before. We're no longer blinded, nearly as blinded as we were before. The notion of shifting our perception is not nearly as difficult as it was before. And so, of course, we realize, wow, this is a big change. This is like a title change, actually. So in these videos, what we experience is a title change. And of course, a rising tide, a change in tide, you know, affects all ships, doesn't it? So when we seeing this, it affects our total psyche. Everything is affected. So this is why I say there's this wowness that this doesn't leave anything untouched. This is a... shift in landscape. So we are not the same psyche as we were half an hour ago. St. Paul said, I die daily. I mean, he was doing practicing. He was practicing, actually. This is the testimony of someone who's actually practicing. Meaning my makeup, my belief system has fundamentally shifted, and the old one is gone. This changes everything. So yeah, I am not the same belief system I was a half an hour ago. It's irreversibly changed. Yes, I already know. I've already irreversibly changed my belief system. Yes, I already know. I've already irreversibly changed my belief system. Yes, I already know. I've already irreversibly changed my belief system. Okay, normalize it. Yes, I already know that I've already irreversibly changed my belief system. Yes, I already know that I have already irreversibly changed my belief system. Yes, I already know that I've already irreversibly changed my belief system. So own it, what happened. This is helping us own it. Assertions of ownage. Yes, I already know I have already irreversibly changed my belief system. Yes, I already know that I have already irreversibly changed my belief system. Yes, I already know that I have already irreversibly changed my belief system. Now, we don't lay any guidelines as how long the wow lasts, because it depends on how intense the recognition is. It's not like you say, well, after 10 minutes it should be dissipating. No. Sometimes the wow is so strong it lasts the whole day. But we get used to it. And this one is very strong. Very, very strong. Which is great. That means we're making super great progress. It's more important to let this sink in than it is to try and scramble for a bunch more insight. Because letting this sink in, it is such an important insight that it will carry the day, for sure. It will carry us to the day. It will carry us to the fullness of the day. Yes, who needs the day? Who needs the dawn when they already have the day? Yes, I already know I don't need the dawn because I already have the day. It's the dawn that's imagination. It's the day that's the reality. So, forgive ourselves for falling into this trap, because it's the intense skepticism of this world. Coming into this world, it's very difficult because of this extraordinarily intense skepticism towards experiencing, someone saying, I'm experiencing the fullness of the day right now. Everybody in the world will insist that you're only have a vivid imagination and it's not true, and they actually need therapy to get you out of that vivid imagination, because it's not healthy for you. It's not mentally healthy for you. That they say you're going to have mental health problems with that. No, it's the ones that are clinging to the illusion of dawn that are going to have mental health problems. And they say, how dare you be so arrogant to say we're going to have mental health problems? Well, you just said I'm going to have it, you know. How dare you, you know. And the thing is, with all these numbers, everyone is very bold to assert this because they think everyone will back them up, right? So they don't even take a look to see if it's true or not. They say, I can, you know, enforce this upon you, so why do I need to even look if it's true or not? This is the trouble, right? So at least we have some hope now. At least we have some hope here. We've identified we have identified this very important area, and we're able to look at it. Now, will it resolve or not? Well, I don't, right now, I'm not trying to answer that question. Too much wow going on. It either will or it won't. And so that's the answer. And so let's just keep letting the wow do its work here. Let the wow do its work. Let the wow do its work. Let the wow do its work. The world is complaining. There's an example. That's okay. So just maintain your quiet sitting. Don't slouch. Sit up straight. Don't goof off. Don't slouch. Don't goof off. Don't get goofy. Now this is a whole constellation. The wow is a constellation. It's also regret, a sadness that you've been suffering all this time and you didn't really need to, that you were actually right all along. You know, it's a whole constellation of reactions here. There's aha. I really was right. Truth really is true. I, you know, and the world really is crazy. The world really has it upside down and backwards. See this cat here, there's a cat and it's drinking water, and suddenly it heard a bird. It stops drinking water and it's stalking the bird now. It's got a, you know, its attention is completely fixated on that. See, this is what we don't want to do. When we're drinking water, drink the water, and we're finished, just sit there. Don't let your attention get fixated on something. Well, there's another bird that just came down right behind it. It didn't even see that bird. It's so fixated on another bird. It didn't even see there's one just landed right on the sidewalk right behind it. Interesting. So don't go chasing after anything. Full stop on the wow means don't go chasing after anything. Don't let your attention get fixated on anything. Keep it unfixated. Keep your no spin, no fixation. Unfixated attention. Here. We know we've already hit a home run here. So just walk, you know, walk, trot around the bases. And go sit down. You already hit the home run. Now, does this end the game? Well, maybe it helps. Maybe it is a game winner. It helps. doing this makes it much easier to get back to it at some point, which you'll need to do, because again, the skepticism of the world is so extreme. It seems to make a barrier there, as if there's some sort of barrier. There's no barrier. It's just the ridicule and skepticism of this world is the barrier to shifting perception. Shifting perception is so easy. It's the easiest of the easiestness. It's the very definition of ease, of easy. So there's no barrier to shift our perception at all. It's the tremendous skepticism of the world, and hostility and ridicule, mockery, patronizing, all this stuff, claiming you're going to end up with mental illness from this imagination and all this kind of stuff. This is what is the barrier. But there's no actual barrier at all. So forget about technique. There's no technique to it, actually. It's like automatic. Once you decide, it's like so easy. It's just like automatic. Your attention just relaxes into the new perception. So don't focus on technique. Focus on this shock of recognition and letting this cool down. Because when we're finally feel okay, the ridicule is not going to bother me that much, and we decide okay, then the shift of perception will take place automatically. It doesn't have to be forced at all. And so we don't need to fixate on how to do it. Not at all. So the threat, what do they threaten you with? What are we threatened with? Well, mental illness, they say we're going to... Well, that's what mental illness meaning. Your mind is not going to be optimally... You won't have optimal mental health. That's what they claim. That you're not a realist. That your lack of that... Well, not quite ready. Not quite ready to look at it. The wow is still there. See, don't struggle with the struggle. If the struggle is still there, and then you try to go on and clarify, you're going to start struggling. So if you try to start flipping the script by clarifying, you're flipping the script, and you start to really struggle, back off, and you say, no, I'm still in the wow phase. But where you can go in and flipping the script seems easy, and then you realize, okay, then the wow has settled down enough, I can do this. So this is how you know. Don't struggle with the struggle. And so you may think that you need to prove that you're not mentally impaired, so you need to like talk and explain. This is why the spiritual path cannot be done effectively by including those who are fundamentally skeptical and trying to derail you, because then you will feel pressured to short circuit the wow and try to show them how good your mental health is, right? By conceptualizing to them, explaining, conceptualizing, as if that's some kind of mark of mental health. They have things upside down and backwards. So just staying in this wow is itself very helpful. And that in itself is also a wow. Staying in the wow is a wow too, because you're not capitulating to the demands that you give evidence to others of your lack of mental impairment, because they think for sure you're going towards mental impairment of some sorts, which they'll claim that you're hallucinating. Imagining. And they say that you'll build your whole psyche, you put all your eggs in the basket, and they say, but then when you realize it was only a dream, you're going to be, you know, devastated. Again, they're projecting the fact what they're in is actually a dream, and that you've awoken from the dream, but they project it upon you as if you're the one who's dreaming, and that you don't take it seriously, or else you're going to end up being distraught, and then when you lose it, defending against the loss of it, and you have all sorts of mental problems, etc., which is really what the problems they're suffering from, is believing they lost it, believing that they didn't lose it, they didn't turn away from it, that somehow they realized it was incomplete, it was bornness. You see, they're still in denial that all this is just a whimsical game in an attempt to deceive God. They say, no, this actually happened, that we realized that reality was just a dream. And the only way to escape it is to identify with this bornness. This is a way to try to trick God. It's like going to God and saying, hey, God, we realize that reality is actually a dream. And the only way to escape it is to identify with this, with bornness, with time, space, process, and form. So they're still unrepentant. They're still, you know, believing in that. Now, see, we have to be in touch. We don't know how intense the wow is. We have to be very sensitive and be aware of it, which I say, don't take any stimulants at all. You have to be aware, because we're so confused that we're not able to really intellectually determine, well, how intense should this wow be, because we don't really know what our problem exactly is. So we just have to have this attitude, well, however intense it is, that's okay. I'll just discover this, and we'll just find out by sitting here quietly. Now, this one feels very strong. But intellectually, how can we figure that out? We don't have very little basis to do so. So don't try to quantify your reactions, the wow. Don't try to quantify it. Don't say, well, it should have been only lasted 10 minutes because I think this is how strong it should be. No, that's using the intellect to short-circuit the whole situation. We don't know how intense it will be and how long it will last. The best way to save time is to give this some time. Give the wow some time. That's how you save time. I'm going to stop this, and then I'll edit in the next one. So, we're just still in the wow, still in the wow mode. Starting to settle a little bit. But keep in mind that our fundamental outlook has shifted. So if we charge ahead with our intellect, we might start making all sorts of mistakes and blunders, because actually our outlook has changed now. And the intellect is going on the past of what our outlook used to be. So it'll start thinking this way and this way and this way, and it'll all feel wrong. And then you think, wow, what's going on? Maybe I really am got problems. No, it's because we've actually have less problems now. We're going towards sanity, and the intellect is still operating as if the old way, where we were not quite as sane as we are now, and so it's making mistakes. This is not a sign of mental impairment. It's a sign that we have shifted our landscape, so to speak. It's like we're on autopilot, when you're driving on autopilot, and what if somebody like somehow shifted the roads, you know, and you just like, you'll keep driving on autopilot, like, whoa, wait a minute, whoa, what, can't turn here, what the heck is that? and so you'll act as like you're not a very good driver, because you're getting shocked by all this stuff. We're in autopilot, you say, oh, this is easy, you know. So the intellect is very much on autopilot. So we don't want to try and navigate the new landscape too quickly here. And there's some road here that used to have a right turn lane that you could turn like this, and then they put in some big island there of plants and everything, completely blocked it off. I have no idea why. It's just stupid. And yet, if you're on autopilot and that hasn't registered yet, you're gonna like get over there and say, "Whoa, wait a minute! I can't turn. What's going on? How do I turn?" And you'll get real uncertain. And then if somebody's with you in the car, they'll say, "Oh, look at them. They don't really know how to drive very good. There's something wrong with them." And then they'll justify their skepticism of your driving, right? So, it's better that you don't try to navigate intellectually the new terrain right off the bat. Let it settle in. And then start to carefully say, hey, yeah, there's a lot of changes that have already taken place here. A lot of changes. We're not going to categorize them. Something will gradually start to clarify. Maybe just drive around the block first, right? So you're not so jittery. Talk about the weather. Another California day, 80 degrees. Just, you know, gorgeous, gorgeous day. Like summer. Not quite that far, but close. And everybody's out frantically trying to soak it in. Except for us. We're just soaking in this great, you know, recognition. Which we can't even remember at this point, so that's which is fine. We will certainly be able to. It becomes part of us. The more we just full stop in the mouth, it becomes part of us, so it's easy. And then something else will come up, which is even better, actually. We might not even have to go back to it, because the progress may just be, you know, exponential. Who needs the dawn when they already have the day? You know, I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. We can go back to our simple assertion, which is fine. This is how assertions help us too. Is instead of trying to intellectually navigate the new terrain, go back to the assertion. So go back to the assertion. I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. As I already know, I don't need the dawn because I already have the day. I already know I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. This is what started it out. I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. So our focus is on the day, isn't it? The day of complete, already complete unbornness. Already perfectly complete unbornness. Already perfectly complete unbornness. Already perfectly complete unbornness. So I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. So I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. I don't need the dawn, I already have the day. And the even more basic assertion, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. If you want to go back to that one, that's the safety net under all the rest. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So if we're trapeze artists, you know, we've got the safety net, we already have the safety net. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Know that we have the safety net, knowing we have it, then we can go up on the high wires. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So maybe as soon as you're enlightened, the skepticism will start in, which is the skill saw is demonstrating this. As soon as I try to start this video, that's when it started. It's been going ever since. So certainly the skepticism of the world will be there, but the saw has not been bothering me at all. I've hardly noticed it, you know. And it's certainly not affecting the ability to hear what's being said. So for those who have ears to hear, the skepticism of the world is not going to interfere with hearing what needs to be heard. But it'll certainly be there. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I'm free. I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. I already know I don't need the dawn because I already have the day. Don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Don't need the dawn. I already have the day. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Activity, activity, activity. Of all those who are frantically identifying with the conventional belief of bornness, trying to get everything to be born, you know, it's like trying to get God to be born. So that we can then claim that this bornness, this is the reality, this is reality, and that the unbornness was a dream of trying to completely reverse truth, completely reverse it, turn it into a lie. So we're all frantically engaged in this convention of bornness that we define, we believe, we have faith. It's all faith-based. We have faith that all everything has actually been born. Full stop in the wow. We're still processing all this. Keep in mind that this is the ultimate realization that nothing has ever been born, that all is and always has been completely unborn, and that all belief in bornness, birth, bornness, is just completely based on faith and our desire to believe it. Desire to believe is faith. And there's no reality to it whatsoever. So of course we're going to have some shock here, because this is so, so advanced, for sure. Even if we're very advanced, you know, it's of course it's still going to register like. So we're just keeping our poise here, just staying centered and keeping our poise in the light of this shocking, startling, shocking truth, that recognition. this is not, you know, it's taking a while to settle down, for sure. For sure. And but this is the whole idea of practicing, is getting to that which really brings about, you know, tremendous encouragement and optimism that is a bit unnerving. We're not trying to shift our perception. That will happen automatically. The fullness of the day is already here. It's not imagination, this is true. And the ridicule is, what's the threat that somehow we will suffer at some later point? Well, here it is. Of course, identifying with this convention of bornness, we're trying to deceive God into believing in it, that this is all, that unbornness is imagination. So if we're believing in unbornness along with God, the mockers will say, well, you know, you haven't got it yet, and so you're behind, you're actually lagging way behind, and this is a sign of bad mental health. They'll define you as having bad mental health. It's like a cup with no bottom, and they're pouring water into it, and they claim they're filling the cup up. So the powerful shocks of recognition can last all day. And there's some ones that are more powerful than others. So just let it last. That's okay. Don't try to stop it. Just let it be there. I don't need the dawn when I already have the day. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. So we'll just go over and reinforce this. I'm not really able to get into anything different right now. The wow is strong, so strong. I'm not able to flip the script into the next step. So we'll just keep saying, I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know that all is already completely unborn. Yes, I already know that all is already completely unborn. Yes, I already know that all is already completely unborn. Yes, I already know that all is already completely unborn. Now, what are we trying to do? Are we going to be some sort of non-dual, awaken the non-dual, unborn, all-inclusive oneness? Of course. Because who needs the dawn when one already has the day? Who needs the dawn when one already has the day? This is how we look at it. It's simply, well, I don't need the dawn. And since we don't need the dawn, we let go of the dawn, and we're in abiding in the all-inclusive, unborn, non-dual oneness. Just like that. It's simply by realizing I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. It's like saying, I don't need the candle. I've already got the sun. Sun's already shining. I don't need this candle. It's stupid. Just set the candle down. It's the middle of the day. It's blazing. Everything is lit up with light. I don't need this candle. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I'm already enlightened. Of course. We simply don't need the dawn. And then relaxing our attention off of the dawn, we see it's already the day. It's as if we have this little candle and all our attention is on the candle, and we're frantically trying to keep this candle going, you know, and it's flickering, and all we do is relax our attention off the candle flame, and we see, oh, it's already day, fullness of the day. And then we say, oh my God, why am I worried about the candle? I had all my attention fixated on the candle. Yeah, we are like walking around with a candle, thinking that this candle is all important. We can't see without it. Everything will be dark without it. We've got to try to desperately keep it alive. And yet, relax our attention off the candle, and all is the fullness of the day. It's the fullness of complete unbornness. It's the fullness of all-inclusiveness. It's the fullness of oneness. It's the fullness of non-dualness. It's the fullness of complete unbornness. It's the fullness of godness. Right here, right now. And we just didn't see it because all our attention was on that little candle. So are we going towards being some non-dual realizers? Well, of course, because we simply realize we don't need the candle. Who needs the candle when you have the sun? Who needs the dawn when you have the fullness of the day? Already have it. It's like we have attention on shadows, trying to figure out what's there by looking at shadows, as if there's no light on what's there at all. That only we can only know what exists through looking at shadows. And of course, shadows are always changing here, and we're like, oh man, this is difficult. I don't really know. Well, if we took our attention off the shadows, we realized everything is already here. Everything is already unborn. The pure potential is already here. The pure potential is always here. The fullness of the pure potential is always here. Nothing is ever separated from pure potential. Nothing is ever separated from Godness. So it's never been born. See, it's never separated from Godness. It's still simply a temporary appearance, an experiencing of pure potentiality. All is already the Godness. All is already the fullness of the Godness. All is already Godness. God is already the world. Yes, I already know that God is already the world. Yes, I already know that God is already the world. Yes, I already know that God is already the world. Yes, I already know that God is already the world. Yes, I already know that God is already the world. Yes, I already know that God is already the world. All of it. Yes, I already know that God is already all of the world. Yes, I already know that God is already all that is. Yes, I already know that God is already all that is. Yes, I already know that God is all already all that is. Yes, I already know that God is already all that is. Yes, I already know that God is already all that is. Yes, I already know that God is already all that is. Yes, I already know that I already have the fullness of the day. Yes, I already know I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. So I feel this is a very powerful. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. So groove this one in your mind. Get it really grooved. Yes, I already know. I don't need the day. The dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Yes, I already know. I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. Stay severely modest and humble, and don't extrapolate success. Just keep focusing on the practicing. Yes, I already know. I don't need success. I'm already here. Yes, I already know. I don't need success. I'm already here. Yes, I already know. I don't know. I don't need success. All right, we're having a lot of dropouts here of the Wi-Fi connection. So I'm still in the wow mode here, and which is great. And this will seems like it's going to continue for a while, which is great. So we'll wrap this video up, and if you're still in the wow mode, just that's great, that's fine, it's not a problem. I already know I don't need the dawn. I already have the day. I already know I don't need the dawn. I already have the day of complete, perfect unbornness. I already have that day. I already have that day. I already have that day. Okay. Very great. And let's call it a wrap on this one.